Well, our backyard has been transformed into a beach oasis. Oh, yes, it has. For Arvada's Sand in the City, Cami Welch and Jean Gordon are getting ready for a great summer event. This is fun.
Yes.
All right. Well, talk to us about what the Sand in the City event is all about.
Absolutely. So this is our fourth year doing Sand in the City. It's a two-day sand sculpture competition and festival.
Love it.
We expect over 15,000 people to come out. It is just a blast, a little something for everybody.
I know. How many years has this been going on?
4 years.
Four years. Yeah. Okay. This is the first I heard about. This is fun. And so where does it take place? And there's, okay, not a lot of sand.
No.
And so where's this sand coming from?
I can assure you it's quite the endeavor getting this much sand into Arvada. We do actually bring in over 120 tons of sand, so it's trucks and trucks of sand. Mm-hmm. We hold the event at a beautiful park in Arvada. It's Ralston Park. It's at 64th and Sims, and it gets transformed into a beach oasis. It's fabulous.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. Okay. What kind of sculptures are we going to see, Jean?
We're going to see some fun ones this year. We have themes around Harry Potter, Finding Dory, Secret Life of Pets. Even a very unique one, our master sculptors on Saturday will be creating a life-size photo booth out of sand. So come on out and get your favorite selfie taken there.
In a sand sculpture. How do you pick the sand sculpture teams?
A little bit of a partnership. Some people do reach out to us, and we've had year over year, they've participated. We also do some friendly recruiting for a couple of others. So this year we're going to have 9 teams competing, including our past champ, Arvada Young Professionals. So they won last year, so they're back on. So exciting to see what they
do. Look at those sculptures. Yeah. It's really neat to see those. All right, so you have lots to do. There will be plenty to do at this sand party. So take us through what you brought here today.
Absolutely. So just a little sampling. We're going to have over 80 vendors at the event both days. Odyssey Beer Works, local brewer in Arvada, will be there. They're always a favorite. Steuben's in Arvada will be there on Sunday with their food truck. Famous Cheeseburger award winning, their BLT.
Looks delicious.
Looking at my notes here, new for us is Samples World Bistro. This is a duck confit kimchi taco with sweet heat chili sauce. Carolina short rib sliders with broccoli slaw and a fried cheesecake with strawberry glaze. Moving on to some of our vendors, this is a college student. Jenny Stanley with J Leather Lotus. She does all custom leather bags. You mentioned you saw us on Colorado & Company, 10% off whatever you purchase in San Diego City. Local Arvada nonprofit, Hearts and Hands, doing some bracelets and other jewelry at the event. So tons to eat, drink, shop.
Yeah, the food looks incredible, incredible. So entertainment is also a really important part of this event.
It is.
So including a couple of luau's.
Yes.
What's that all about?
Yeah, so we have fully embraced the beach theme, and both days we do have luau's. We also have an amazing steel drum band called Urban Island that we'll be rocking on Saturday.
Sounds very apropos.
On Sunday. And then Saturday we have a band that will be doing some Beach Boys and some really fun music around that.
And there's a lot for the kids to do, of course.
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
So they should bring sand buckets, because I'm sure there's all kinds of sand.
There are. And actually, the first 200 kiddos each day will receive a sand bucket from us.
Oh,
so join us early in the day, and we'll definitely hand that to them. There'll be activities that will take up hours of entertainment for these kids, so the parents will be happy as well. We have a giant sandbox, bigger this year than ever before. We also have face painting, balloon artist, magician, a museum that's in a bus that's very, very cool. So a little something for all ages, but the kids will have a blast and be entertained for hours.
This is neat. I have to know, what happens to all that sand that gets trucked in? What do you do with it afterwards?
Well, each year is a little bit different. We do tend to get people Sunday afternoon that are like, can I take some sand back home?
Go for it, yes.
Please,
yes.
To make our life a little easier on the haul out. But we are glad to share the sand this year with the city of Arvada that has some projects on the west side, so they will be taking it for us after the event.
Very good.
Yeah.
You might see it in some local parks. So, Jean, what are you looking forward to most about this year's event?
I think that we have kicked it up 10 notches in the entertainment zone. So whether you're perusing the sculptures or doing a shopping and eating, please come and stay for the luau's. We have one each day, some great live music, and there's nothing better than having a beach blanket, taking a look at the stage, and just kicking back. So
I
think our entertainment would be a great surprise for everyone.
Absolutely. All right, I know it's been 4 years and dozens of sand sculptures, but you have to have a favorite over the years. What's been yours?
Oh my gosh, there's so many to choose from. I was so impressed last year. We have a team 4BR. They're in their third year this year, but they did a remake of Red Rocks Amphitheater that was amazing. So they did an awesome job on that. And I think this year's sculptures are going to be better than we've ever seen before. Our teams do practice. They actually go through a whole series of things that they have to get ready for Friday when they build the sculptures. And when we saw these teams practicing, it was amazing. I was absolutely floored by the quality of work they have this year.
Wow.
So it'll be great.
Jean, what about you? A favorite?
Do you know, I think it might be last year's, we had a Monopoly-themed one. And just Monopoly. The level of detail where they recreated just every little nuance was pretty incredible. Oh. Just looking back, this is out of sand. So they're working hard to put on a good product.
Whether it's ice or sand, you know, if you can keep it together and make it look like something, it's amazing.
Exactly.
It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Okay, so how much does it cost for families to come and participate?
Absolutely. So it's only $5 for adults to come in. Kids 12 and under are free to join us. And what we've done this year is we've partnered with Jeffco Schools Foundation, and so a good portion of those proceeds will be going back to that amazing organization. In addition, we've upped the amount of entertainment and free activities for the kids. So free face painting, free balloon artists, absolutely fabulous for all the kids.
All right, let's look at this food again. While it looks delicious, it's all going to be available. Yes. So tell me, run through again, if you can.
Absolutely. Yeah. Odyssey Beer Works, Steuben's in Arvada, Samples World Bistro. This is J Leather Lotus, and that's Hearts and Hands in Richmond.
I want one of each.
Yes,
one of each.
Awesome.
All right, ladies, this sounds like so much fun. So, and it starts at what time? We don't want to miss it.
11 a.m. both
starts
days.
Starts at 11 a.m. both days.
Yes.
Be there early. You know, it's going to be a beautiful weekend. It's
perfect
been beautiful.
Weather. Yep.
It's perfect weather. So get there early.
Yay.
Will sculptures be ready on Saturday morning?
They will be.
The
teams build on Friday, and they get judged Friday. We announce the winners, and then it's open to the public starting Saturday at 11.
And now folks can watch on Friday when they're building them, or is it kind of...
If people were to swing by, we wouldn't boot them.
Okay.
But we're hoping to let the teams focus on their building.
Yes. I just slid that in there just in case.
Because later in the day, you can probably get a sneak peek.
I'm sure that's quite a sight.
Yes.
Quite a sight. Thank you both so
much.
This was fun. Absolutely. So Sand in the City by the Arvada Chamber of Commerce takes place in Arvada June 25th and 26th at Ralston Park, which is 64th and Sims. You know where it's at. For full details, go to sandinthecityarvada.org, or you can call 303-424-0313.